Mr. Sanjay Kirloskar, who is not here today, he was in the morning, he was there, but he was not able to make it. Mr. Hakimuddin Ali, Mr. Ashwini Malhotra, Mr. Kaushalendra Sinha, my friend from Mumbai, other distinguished dignitaries, and a very special investors who are present here who want to invest in Vidarbha, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, in the morning, I spoke about Saraswati. And that when Ganga and Jamuna meet, Saraswati is not seen, but it's still present. So we assumed your presence in the morning, and Sri Ganesh started the episode. But हमने कहा था मिलेंगे break के बाद. So thank you very much for. So one of the things I said is दिल में एक लहर सी उठी है अभी, कोई ताजा सी हवा चली है अभी. So in a brief thing, I have a thing in my heart which says, how can we put India on the global stage by Make in India? And how can we put Vidarbha on the stage of India by making Make in India in Vidarbha and in Nagpur at this conference? That's the thing. I believe, sir, there are two things, revolutions, which are in the making, which will help India be in the top of the world. One is the Make in India, and the other is the Green Revolution Stage 2, which will make us go from being a food sufficient nature to becoming the bread basket of the world. Both this, I believe, the center stage can be in this very place where I am standing. Okay. And one of the key things I said when I wanted to learn, and I joined Mahindra, they sent me to Nagpur to learn, and to my Mahindra plant here to learn, and I am doing very well. Part of it, no, by no means a small measure, to the training I received here. So thank you, Nagpur. Thank you, Mahindra plant here. So with that, I just wanted to kind of go back and talk about a couple of things which bothers us. I'm not going to go through my entire presentation, sir, for the simple reason you have reduced the time, and I would rather pick up the bigger issues than smaller issues. And I think there are four planks that we must focus on: the policy framework, the resources framework, the finance framework, and the talent framework. If I address these four, I believe that we can make this, what we have started as a small experiment of Mahindra, as one plant here, can be a big place for everything. In the policy framework, I have one list. Policies to attract investment is a very important thing. We have a good example within Maharashtra in Chakan. And now we have possibility of Nagpur being part of NIMS. Okay, while I'm not fully aware of the detail, but I think that is some clarion call we can have of how investment can happen. The other aspect is basically, as we go along, one of the key things we need to do is delivering on promises on an ongoing basis. So we do promise, but we keep those promises and consistent and speedy delivery and speedy resolution. I have one example which I shared in the morning. Let me kind of reiterate that feeling. Earlier, what used to take months, I'm already seeing hopes. Where there are no roads or no paths, now paths are being visible. Where there are paths, they are being cemented. And sir, I believe this is just the start point of seeing consistent and speedy resolution. And I think policy framework rests on this. Otherwise, it's a sheet of papers which is written. So I'm going to kind of suggest that we must carry on this good work which has already seen the start. The second one is resources. Who can argue that Vidarbha is short of any resource? So whether you talk about mineral, forest, wealth, yeah, everything, there are many, many things this, and it occupies about roughly little less than 1/3 of the area of Maharashtra, and about 21.3% of the population. So there is huge amount of opportunity. It is a power surplus based, but power is high cost, and that's something that we need to kind of look at. How do we make that attractive to the producer? When we make in India, power is an important cost. But more, last but not least, this is the best. I mean, and somebody made it better than I did, and I hope that MLA is here on the in the audience. If not, I will say it on his behalf. If Gateway of India is Mumbai, Gateway of India is actually Nagpur, because it's the exact center in that. Yeah, and logistics-wise,
this is the gateway to India. So one can really make it as is to reduce it if all the other things will come in for a thing. In terms of labor, sir, I wanted to start by saying that Saraswati also made one more announcement, the point, which is you announced, I think, the IIM at Nagpur. And this has made the education platform even stronger. It already boasts of 70 plus engineering college and good education system and availability of labor only. We have never found availability of either labor or managerial talent ever a problem in Nagpur. So that's one thing which is very interesting. Finance. We need more bankable projects to come in. That the private sector and the public sector have to work together. And we need to get much more projects which are viable, bankable, and we need to work that close together. And that's some microsystem, some saving environment. This is some proposal that we can talk about. And this is an important aspect as we go along the curve of making Nagpur and Vidarbha the crown jewel of Maharashtra in the Make in India campaign. The key thing that I was thinking, and I'm also the group CIO, so always will end with this, that today is more important and is possible to leverage IT to bridge remoteness, bring the programs together, the expenditure reduction, the progress and outcome evaluation, and also mid-course correction. So IT can become a big bone, and wherever, how much we can use that to our advantage, it'll be good for us. And we have the advantage to leapfrog, that's what. So having said this about the general, I will give a little bit of glimpse about Mahindra, just because that has been part of my brief to talk about it. Yeah, and little bit I also want to talk about it. So Nagpur, we have got 6 plants in Maharashtra. Auto and tractor manufacturing setup. We employ about 20,000 people, 19,000 to be specific, 20 is a little higher. So 19,000 people in Maharashtra in all those plants put together. Sir, Nagpur is our largest tractor plant in Maharashtra. Not only in Maharashtra, in India, and not only in India, in Asia. This is the biggest plant of tractor in the entire Asia. And we employ about 3,000 people in this plant, spread over. Overall, our capital investment has been high here, but the last couple of years, we have invested another 200 crores to upgrade this facility to bring engine assembly, the technology of engine assembly, which Nagpur is now using for just for engines as well as for gensets. And last but not least is that I can proudly say that the latest technology product called Arjun Nova, which is a tractor with new technology. So whatever we're selling in US, we try to bring the same technology to India. And that one is being rolled out from our Nagpur plant. And recently we have kind of not only announced it, but the entire product portfolio of what we call as Arjun platform will be done from Nagpur only. Okay, the next one is that we buy about 11,000 crores from the Maharashtra state. Out of that, which is about 50% of our total buying. However, when it comes to Vidarbha, we buy a very small sum of 400 crores. I'm not looking at it as a negative. I'm looking at it as an opportunity now to see if 7% of localization is what I'm doing. If I did 50% of localization, which is what I'm buying in Maharashtra, how much more employability can we give and how much more entrepreneurship which we can give to town of Nagpur and this region of Vidarbha. Sir, as we say that, you know, money and business is not everything. So some of the thing our Nagpur team does, and I wanted to share, we plant about 100,000 trees every year, and we have done this consistently for last 3 years, and about 600,000 plants and trees are planted by our team in Nagpur. Mobile dispensary, we send out the mobile dispensary every day to one area, and 6 days we cover 6 different areas, so that we can provide not only medical services, but also dispense medicines to the needy people in that area. And every year, we have allocated 1 crore support for farmers of Vidarbha. This is only focused on Vidarbha for yield increase, productivity increase, and better realization. There were some suggestions after the in terms of how we can use it better, and we will do, but this we very specifically focus. There is also one more scheme called as Vijay Vidarbha. Here what we are suggesting doing is that we are taking distressed farmers' family, bringing them to our factory, training them on how to repair and how to work on a tractor, and then they are being employed either with our dealers or many of them become entrepreneurs and mechanics, and this is being put through. So these are some of the things, and again I would require anybody from the team to say it right if I don't say it. We have two locations called Hemal Kasa and Melghat. Every year, once a year in both these places, we are performing major surgeries. Along with Rotary Club, this we are doing, but we are sponsoring and we put people on this. And this does all major surgeries free of cost to the needy of that place. And in Swachh Abhiyan and toilets, there is a major program which is being done by Mahindra and Vidarbha, and Nagpur unit will be part of that Mahindra team doing this. Sir, not only this, we are not just about tractors. Life Spaces is putting up 1200 units already in anticipation that more business will come into this and they will need more place to live, and to give them affordable and good houses, Mahindra Life Spaces will support them with that kind of thing. They've already launched, and 6 months from now the first set of houses will be occupied. So with that, and with a thing, with the advent of the new regime in Maharashtra, we are expecting a facelift to the Vidarbha region under the dynamic and promising leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Devendra Fadnavis. The industry is committed to shoulder this responsibility, sir, in the development of Vidarbha, along with the new government at the state and the center. It's a joint effort of government and industry, which helps in rapid development and inclusive growth. A mutually beneficial arrangement in the form of tax subsidies, backward region development incentive, deferred taxation scheme, subsuming octroi in GST and other infrastructure development initiatives will not only attract new partners, but it will trigger a boom loop. To sum up, there is huge scope, potential, and more importantly, some concrete examples of success. There is hope and eagerness to place Vidarbha as the crown of Maharashtra. But to do that, we have to walk with all stakeholders to make this promise into a reality. Unlike a couplet, let me end by saying a couple of lines from Frost. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. Thank you.